Hello, High Levelers. Rayo Daniel here, and welcome back to my channel. Got another great feature release from you from High Level here. This is regarding email templates and the ability to have to save certain sections of your email templates now, so you don't have to constantly keep rebuilding them. Yay! I know. Everybody's been waiting for this. It's just like you've had to rebuild these emails over and over again, or potentially, you know, copy an email and, you know, clone it and duplicate it and delete the stuff that you didn't want. And just, man, you know, why don't they just templatize this and have little areas where you could save off sections and then rebuild the sections together very quickly? Awesome. Finally, feature is here. But before we get started in this video, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button. I always appreciate your support. Thank you so much. And let's hop into it. So here in this one, what we're going to end up doing is we're going to go into the sites area. I'm sorry, not site, marketing area. Then we're going to go to the email and templates. Now, I've already built one out and I want to show you this, and then I'm going to walk you through creating it just to kind of save time so you don't see me building an email template. Not very exciting on that one, but I call this March newsletter. Now, what this is let's just say every month you have a newsletter for this particular company and you have to build the image and, you know, make it look good and things like that, and put socials and, you know, social marketing campaigns or your links and all that other stuff on here. And you've got little areas for content that you want to drop in, and then you have like a little footer area. Well, that's great, you know, if you want to have a template like this, but rather than having to rebuild this, again, this doesn't take much. This is just like a text box, an image, you know, a divider and a social. I mean, it doesn't take a lot to build that, but some of you really build intricate and complicated email, you know, email templates. So one of the things that you can now do is if you look at each one of these, you see these certain sections over here. You can now take this entire section over here that's at the very top, and now there's just a little save button here. You see, a little cool save button. So right now, if you do that, notice you can just do this. You can clone it, save it, or even trash it. We don't want to trash it. But what we want to do is we want to go ahead and click on save and save this. So that right there will actually take this entire section of your email template and then save it off into a special saved area. You got confirmation that it's been saved. Perfect. Now, what we want to do is we want to go in, and now that we've had this, let's say that next month here, now this could be, I've got this labeled as March newsletter. Let's just say that now it's April and you want to do April newsletter and you want to build it. Well, now, I mean, you could do the same thing to some of these other components if you wanted to, but these are just as easy to kind of just drag and drop over here to create that. But if you have content in these areas that are pre-populated, which is standard stuff, you might want to copy these as well. You could do that, but let's kind of go back and create a new template and see how we can now use these. Hey, real quick, if you're interested in learning some more about the GoHighlevel platform and how you can make money, I have a free course in the description below. Click on the link. I teach you 8 different ways you can make money using the GoHighlevel platform with no money out of pocket. If you haven't signed up for GoHighlevel, there's a link below where you can sign up and get a free trial. Let's get back to the video. So we're going to click on new. We're just going to do a blank one, and we're just going to use the editor. So right now we want to kind of just want to get rid of the start from scratch stuff here, and we don't even want this. We could just remove that content area. But notice up here in the top right, we've got this nice little saved items area. This is the like area that all of those items that you saved get put into. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on the saved items. Now notice, forgive me on this one, I kind of did this twice, but we've got a little section over here that we've saved. We can just simply take this entire section, come over here and drag and drop it, and then bam. There it is. So we don't have to go do it. We could just simply call this your April newsletter. And you see how very quickly, if we take these components, just drag them from the saved area, drop them. Now we can reconfigure them and all the settings. Like, so if you configure all the social media icons and all the links to all the social medias, that's going to be in there included, which is why I included it in here. But you don't have to go relink it and copy and paste all those again. Those will already be there. So all of it will be ready to go. And just now you're able to quickly build your email templates based upon, you know, you can even open up some of your old templates that you had and now create templates from there, so that moving forward, you can quickly build up that save library. And now in the future, with any new emails that you build, any email templates, you can just quickly drag and drop and quickly build very complex and feature-rich emails, all from the saved items that you've already created without having to go through and recreate them over and over again. I know, yay! That's a great feature. So that's really it. I mean, I just want to show you what's capable, where the saved items are, how you would save it, and then how you would simply rebuild your email template. So why don't you go out there, start crushing it, rebuild, and start getting a bunch of your saved templates configured in your email templates that you have. I know it's going to save you a ton of time. But guys, if you like this video, if it was useful, if you got a little, even one piece of information out of it, smash a like button for me here. Leave me a comment. Let me know if it was useful, if you have any other questions about it, or if there's any other new features that you'd like. Guys, thanks so much for tuning into the channel. And as always, I appreciate your support. Have a great day.